With DoubtNit, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry, and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question, and get instant video solution. Download DoubtNit app today.
Hello friends, so here's a question. It says that in a third order determinant, each element of the first column consists of sum of two terms, each element of the second column consists of sum of three terms, and each element of the third column consists of sum of four terms. Then it can be decomposed into four terms. Then it can be decomposed into n determinants where n has value. Okay, so we have a determinant, and then we have to decompose this determinant into n different determinants, and we have to find this value of n. Okay, so let's start. The kind of determinant given here, let me show you how it is. It says that the first column has a sum of two terms each, right? So let's say this one is a1 plus b1, then the second element of this column will be a2 plus b2, and the third one will be a3 plus b3, right? Each one of them will be a sum of two different terms. Then the second column is a sum of three different terms, right? So that will be c1 plus d1 plus e1, right? Similarly, this was c2 plus d2 plus e2, and c3 plus d3 plus e3. And the third column has a sum of four terms, right? So it will be f1 plus g1 plus h1 plus i1, right? So similarly here, f2 plus g2 plus h2 plus i2, and this will be f3 plus g3 plus h3 plus i3, right? Now we have to divide this determinant. Okay, so let's start with this column. Okay, so I can divide this determinant into two different determinants using this first column. How? The one the first determinant will have the first column as a1, a2 and a3, and the second determinant will have its first column as b1, b2 and b3, right? And the second and third column will be as it is, right, in both these determinants, right? So the first way in which we can divide this determinant, using this first column is 2, right? So that is 2 in two ways, right? Now here the second column, which is this, will remain as it is, right? So now if I take this determinant into consideration, then I can divide this particular determinant using the second column, which have the elements like c1 plus d1 plus e1, c2 plus d2 plus e2 and c3 plus d3 plus e3 into three different ways, right? Let me show you. The first one will remain as it is, a1, a2, a3, right? So the first determinant will have its second column as c1, c2, c3. The third column will remain as it is, like this one, okay? Then the second column will have the same first column, that is a1, a2, a3, but the second column will be d1, d2, d3, right? So it will be d1, d2 and d3. Third will remain as it is, the sum of four terms. And then the third determinant will have a1, a2 and a3, and the second column will become e1 plus e2 and e3, right? And the third column will remain as it is, right? The sum of four different terms. So in the second step, we can divide each of these two determinants in three different ways, right? So here we have to multiply 3, right? So right now we had divided this determinant into six different ways, right? The first step was using the first column. Then in the second step, we divided it using the second column. And now in the same way, like this, we can divide these three determinants into four different ways each, right? This can be divided into four ways, this can be in four ways, and this can be in four ways, right? Using the fourth column, right? Let me show you one of them. So one of that determinant will be, I'm using this one, so that will be a1, a2, a3, right? The second column will also remain as it is, c1, c2 and c3. Now here we had the sum of four terms, right? f1 plus g1 plus h1 plus i1, right? So the one of these determinant will have its third column as f1 f2 and f3, right? Similarly, we will have four different determinants, where the third column in the second one will be g1 g2 g3 h1 h2 h3 and then i1 i2 i3, right? So we have to multiply this 2 into 3 into 4, right? So these is the total number of ways in which we can divide this whole determinant, right? So that is actually 24, right? So this will be our answer. Among the given options, option D says 24. So answer will be option D. Okay. I hope this will help you. Thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level. Trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.